Hi everyone, so today I've got a new phone, which means that because it's an iPhone 8, I had an iPhone 6, it doesn't have a port for your microphone. So anyway, I've had to order an adapter from eBay and it's not arrived yet. So please bear with me for a couple of days until that arrives and I can get back to having my microphone on. I'll try and talk a bit louder. So first thing I've got to show you today is that I finished this wig. I made this wig for the Snapstar doll. I'll show you how I did it for those that didn't watch the wig making video. Let's take it off her head. So what I did, I got my double layer of polythene from my polythene bag, put it over the Liv doll's head, not Liv, she's not a Liv doll, is she? She's a Snapstar. Put it over the Snapstar doll's head like this, attached it with a couple of elastics. I then covered all where you can see hair through the polythene with sellotape. So I went round and I sellotaped everywhere you can see hair, I covered with sellotape. This is where your wig is going to be and where you're going to put your hot glue. It doesn't matter if you overlap, it doesn't matter, you know, if you've done more than one layer in some bits and not in others. As long as you've covered the whole of that bit that's got hair on it with at least one layer of sellotape, what happens is that the hot glue melts the sellotape and forms a wig cap when you're gluing on your hair. So pop the plastic bag on, hold it in place with an elastic band, cover everywhere you can see hair with a layer of sellotape, then you get your hot glue gun and your wool, and you put glue just on the end of your piece of wool, press a bit on, wind it round to get rid of the strands of glue, then stick it onto a head like that. If you stick it on at that angle, it'll come out at that angle and you can move it any way you want, like normal hair. Once you've covered the whole of the head like that, you will end up with this. This is what we've got. So then you take it off the doll's head and cut off the excess polythene that's around the edge here. So cut off all the excess polythene. You can see that there's a bit, but in here it's really nice and hard. So I'm going to get my little scissors and I'm just going to trim off that excess polythene or plastic bag, whatever you want to call it. And you can see that that hasn't, let's take this one off it. You can see that it hasn't damaged her head at all using the hot glue over that sellotape and plastic bags. So now I'm just going to snipping off all the excess polythene right up as near as you can to the glue line without actually cutting your hair, cutting the doll's wig at all. Make sure you cut round where the ears were. And you can use the same method for any doll you want, any size doll. You can do it for Liv dolls, you can do it for Snapstars, you can do it for Barbie. Any doll that needs a wig, that's how I do it. It's just a quick and easy way to do it. Now the only thing is, it's not going to be perfect, is it? Because it's not hair, it's wool for a start. I think for the best results for rerouting a doll, you do actually have to reroute her. But this is just me doing a quick, showing you my quick and easy method that I saw on YouTube a couple of years ago, and I've used it a good few times, so I like it because I'm a bit of a, not a fan of rerouting, I'm afraid. Although I do have one or two dolls that I would reroute rather than give this wig to. So I'm now left with my wig cap. It's quite hard, that is. It's not ultra hard, but it's nice and hard that it's not going to fall off her head when you get it on. So we'll put it back on her head. I don't know if I've got it on upside down now. Hold on. I might have it on upside down. That's not going to help, is it? Here we go. I've put it on her head. It's quite heavy, this wig is, because it's quite long. Maybe you wouldn't want yours to be as long. But there we are, she's got it on her head. It fits her really well because it's actually made to measure. And then you can decide what you're going to do with your wig. Are you going to give her a fringe? Are you going to unravel your pieces of wool to make it look more like hair? Are you going to brush it out to give her like candy floss hair, much like my own? You could brush it out to do that. There are a few options there that you can do now that you've got your wig sorted. But I didn't do this one as thick as I did the Creatable World doll. I left it sort of more sparsely. I glued it on a bit more sparsely because I didn't want it to come out as thick as that other one did. I actually really like that colour on her, and it was quite accidental because I actually thought I'd got grey out of the cupboard and I hadn't. When I got it in the daylight, it was green. But yes, so that was that. That's the wig. Well, it's not finished yet, is it? Because I haven't quite decided what I'm going to do with it, but I shall do something with it. You needn't worry. And I'm finding that sliding about on her head a bit. If you wanted to stop it from sliding about on her head, you could just stick a pin all the way through into the hole. She's got a hole in her head anyway, look, just here. If you want to stop it sliding about on her head, you can stick a pin through into that hole and just do that, couldn't you? You could do. You could maybe glue it to her hair with some glue that would come off quite easily. It's all right, I think. Yeah, I actually do quite like that on her. It's quite a nice wig, that is. Yeah, it's not bad at all, is it? For how long it took me to make, I think a couple of hours, compared to rerouting, which would take a much longer time. So that was her wig done. I'm pleased with it, but I haven't quite decided how I'm going to finish it off yet. Then I've got this parcel and I can't for the life of me think what's in it. I'm hoping it's a doll. Let's open it and have a look. I don't remember ordering any dolls this size, that's all. Unless there's more than one doll in there. You can see that it's just all, let's see. No, I think it is just one doll by the look of it. Just one doll wrapped in there and then it's all very well packed. Oh no, there's something in there as well. Oh. Oh. No, I honestly don't know what that is. There's some more pieces to it there. Well, that's it. That's what's in there. Oh, I know what it is. Oh, I know what it is now. I'm so excited. So we've got our stand. It says Barbie Collectible on it. And we've got Curious George. Look at Curious George. How gorgeous is he? Oh, so delighted. And then the little standard Barbie dress in like a pearlescent white there. And then we've got the Curious George Barbie. I've been wanting her for a while and I've not seen her at a price I wanted to pay. But I saw her last week. And here she is. Oh, she's so nice. Look at her. Oh, she's got such a lovely face. Oh, I love her, love her, love her, love her. Right, let's have a look. Her hat's stitched to her head, which is a bit odd, but never mind. That hat doesn't really fit her properly, does it? Here we are. Oh, look at her. She's just lovely. Look at that. She's in lovely condition. Look at that. Like I say, a hat, it's a bit odd how her hat is. It's still tabbed to her head, the hat is. I don't like how this is at the side here. Either should be at the back to me, or yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's just me being daft, eh? The hat doesn't seem to fit properly. Anyway, that's a minor detail. She's got her earrings in, little red stud earrings there. Look at her face, she's so pretty. Look at her lips match her earrings. She's got, I think she's got blue eyes. Yeah, blue eyes. And this like hazelnut brown coloured hair, very similar to that Madame Alexander doll I got the other day. Then her top and skirt are stitched together, but they are separate. You can see they're just held together with a little stitch there, but they are separate, and they are fastened with studs. Look how nice that is. I love the trim on the collar. She's got like a sailor collar with this tie at the front, a little tiny button detail down the front there. Love that. And her skirt is a yellow, her outfit is a yellow check. Yellow and white check, and she's got Curious George around the bottom of her skirt. Look, how nice is that? I love it. Underneath, she's wearing her tights. She's got on some white tights, and she's got on these yellow shoes. I really like those. I'm not a big fan of yellow, but Dale likes yellow. Look at them yellow shoes, Dale. I do actually like them on her because they do match her dress, don't they? She's so nice, though. She's so nice, I love her. Oh, I'm so happy to have her. She'll go on display with my Peter Rabbit Barbie. And have I got any more? No, I've just got Peter Rabbit and Curious George at the minute. And I sort of put Jane from Tarzan in with those as well. I don't know why, because she's not really, she's more of a Disney doll, isn't she? But she sort of, she seems to fit in better with these, I think, than she does with the others. So, yeah. So that was my dolliness for today. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.